What's going on, everyone? Today we're here with Brother Yakinon. Now, a year ago, Brother Yakinon joined us for our very first interview. So we definitely want to welcome him back to the show. Brother Yakinon, thank you for joining.
All right, I appreciate it, Brother Phil. It's always good to be back. It's good seeing you again. And most importantly, it's time for us to have this needed conversation one more time.
Yes, sir. So Philando Castile didn't get any justice yesterday. We all watched the Facebook Live video where the cop murdered Philando Castile. His girlfriend, Diamond Reynolds, had the video for the whole world to see. Her four-year-old daughter was consoling her while Philando Castile was bleeding out. The trial happened. The cop got away scot-free. The jury consisted of 10 Caucasians and 2 black people. What is your opinion on the case?
Well, I was doing a little running around yesterday, so I just got wind, you know, that the verdict came down. But this morning, I got the opportunity to sit down and view some footage, you know, of the verdict being coming down and seeing the reaction of the family. And as a grown man, you know, I actually sat there and I wept. I weep all the time when I see these verdicts come down. You know, I'm very compassionate about this. You know, my condolences go out to the family, and when they go through something like that, you know, we go through it as well with them. You know, just because they're in Minnesota and we down here in Houston, Texas, we feel their pain as well, because that's who we are. We associate with these families, and we feel for them, and our heart goes out to them.
We are spiritually connected to feel the pain of our brothers and sisters, not only in America, but throughout the world. But many people in our community has asked, how do we unify? What are the steps that we must take to do that?
Well, what we need to do is we need to really sit down and do like Michael Jackson asked us to do. You know, we have to really look at the man in the mirror. We have to know who we are as a people, because most black people are in delusion. You know what I mean? We've been kidnapped, brought over here. You know, we've been raised in someone else's culture and everything else. Everything has been defined for us. So, you know, we have been taught to love our enemies. We've been taught to forgive. And so what we have to do at this point, we need some real true leadership to step up. You know, the government has the COINTELPRO program put in place, you know, to stop the rise of the next black messiah, because they know who we are, but we don't know who we are. You know, they'll use the language messiah, you know, in their language when they're talking, the coding that they use, and we have to go back and explore all these things and really see exactly what it is that they're talking about. You know, me personally, I know exactly where they're coming from. Because, you know, they know that our leaders will rise up in times of chaos like this. And if you take away a leader, you can take one bullet and you can take away the hearts of millions of people. We are surrounded. We are behind enemy lines. You know, we are behind, we are in their territory. And we sit in these situations time and time again, you know, and that question is often asked. And it's a question that I had to ask a long time ago. So what I decided to do, I decided to take another trip up to that mountaintop again and have a long conversation with our Creator. As individuals, we have to step up to the plate. You know, we need grown men to step up. We got so many boys running around here, and we got women laying up with these grown men, you know, and they basically a bunch of simps. They living in fear, and all they want to do is party, have fun. They not going to do nothing at all whatsoever. So, you know, we have to start stepping our game up to the plate. We have to start unifying, identifying everybody who is willing and ready to unify with us, and anybody that is not willing to unify and build a coalition, and they just in it for the money, hopping in their 500 double low Benzes in their three-piece suits going home to their two-story and three-story houses while the people still out here suffering. All those things have to be identified in our community.
It seems like a section of our community don't want liberation. They will say things like, it doesn't involve me and I don't see race. What do you say to those black people who don't have a clue about the system they're living in?
Well, it's not a whole lot to say. You can present the facts to them. You can sit down and try to reason with them, but they don't want to come to a reason, so they just have to be left by the wayside. You know, it doesn't take a whole lot of us. You know, I remember the story of 300, you know, in the scriptures, you know, to where, you know, the glory should go to God. If we do it as men ourselves and it's just us alone, we'll never go back and give God the glory for bringing us out of this situation. But as we continue to take to the streets, I don't think people really truly understand who and what they are crying out for. They're crying out for justice, and they will receive justice at the end of the day. But we have to be a righteous people. You know, and it's a simple understanding that we should have. You know, we can go outside and use something as simple as a tree. Whenever a limb breaks off of a tree, you know, it's not gonna continue to produce fruit anymore. It's gonna wither and die. And that's what we're doing. We have broken off from our root. We have gotten away from who we are as a people. So we just wither and fruit anymore. And we have to return back to who we are, being righteous, being good in our hearts, being good to one another, and quit taking upon the wicked ways of the oppressor. Because right now we view each other through the oppressor's eyes. Our value has become so low, you know, that we are worth nothing. And we're being shown that in the courtroom. We're being shown, on the streets, on these videos every day. We have to quit believing in this system that we were brought up to believe in, that was going to bring us truth, justice, righteousness, one nation under God, all of that nonsense. It's so many lies that we've been told. We just have to actually face the facts, you know, of what happened to us. Now, had it happened to one of our children, if your son was kidnapped or my child was kidnapped, and they were taught another language, taught to praise another people's God, taught in another people's education, and we seen our child in that condition, then we would understand. But we sit here like lions that have been born in a cage, and we don't understand our condition. You know, had we, a lion in the wild is not gonna sit in a cage, you know, with one white man and a whip and jump through hoops of fire, nothing like that. So we have been born into this situation, and without really realizing exactly what's going on with us. And it's not that complicated at all.
What young people should do to understand the system? Should they read books or join groups like yours?
Yeah, most definitely. We are the frontier. We are stepping up to the plate. We're going to be the leaders of this movement, the People's New Black Panther Party. We're not here to rape the people at all. We talk to people about politics, waking up to their political consciousness, because people haven't been taught. No enemy is going to teach you how to rule. You know, a master is not going to teach a slave how to rule. A pimp is not going to teach one of his prostitutes how to be free at all whatsoever. So we have to have that understanding and that mind state going into this, that these people are not going to educate us and tell us and equip us with the tools that we need in order to move forward. The only thing that they're going to do is continue to do what they have done always in the past, what has continued to work for them, and that's to keep us oppressed through miseducation and other means.
On our channel, we promote to black people to practice their Second Amendment rights. In your group, you practice your Second Amendment rights. But why is it, for the most part, a lot of black people are afraid to practice their Second Amendment rights?
Well, just out of fear. You know, it's even though it's a Second Amendment right for us to bear arms, well, we also know that it's a taboo. It's something that we're not supposed to be doing. You know, white men can do it. You can look at the videos of them walking down the street carrying their weapons. But if we do it, somebody's going to end up calling the police, and you can end up dead just for so-called practicing your rights. But that's something that's different between us and them. You know, it's written out, but it only applies for them in a positive manner. Anytime we try to use all of our political tools, you know, the heavy arm is brought down on us.
You have groups like the Huey P. Newton Gun Club. How can people join the Huey P. Newton Gun Club in the Dallas area? Because there's a lot of people in our community who are afraid, and they just want to protect themselves.
The Huey P. Newton Gun Club is not just in Dallas. It's a national organization. So in order to join, you could go to email at hpngc2014@gmail.com. And that's an easy way for you to go ahead and get in touch with us and sign up. Because I'm also a member of the Huey P. Newton Gun Club and the People's Party. We're a coalition. We have built the coalition. Shout out to the comrade Babu Omawale down there in Dallas. He's a co-founder of the Huey P. Newton Gun Club and also our former national chairman of the People's New Black Panther Party.
Bill Cosby was accused by 40 women, mostly Caucasian women, that he drugged them and raped them. They even called him Bill Cosby. Now, the trial has just ended in a mistrial. What is your opinion on brothers always getting caught up with Caucasian females?
We haven't learned yet. You know, time and time again, we keep seeing the same thing. It's sad. We got a situation going on in Sulphur Springs with some brothers. These brothers need to stay away from these Caucasian women in any and every way, shape, form, and fashion. Bill Cosby does not need to spend the rest of his life in jail. This was obviously something that was done based on politics. Bill Cosby has been in a couple of situations, dealing with this. You know, I remember his son was killed, many years ago. And, you know, here we have this situation coming up with Bill Cosby that's coming up from, you know, this 30 years ago, 30, 40 years ago. You got cases popping up from the 60s and the 70s. And I put Bill Cosby in a category with Michael Vick, you know, Muhammad Ali. You know, they're always bringing down our heroes, you know, for their advancement in politics.
Now, when I say the same things you just said, brother, I'm attacked, because we have some brothers that promote being with Caucasian females, and also we have some sisters that's out here promoting it, creating websites, and saying very vile things about black men. Now, we take Serena Williams. She's with a Caucasian male, pregnant by him, and you had a Caucasian female treated her very racist, speaking ill of her child. And the Caucasian male that she's with didn't say a word at all. Why do black people think they're going to break code to be with one of us?
Been brainwashed. You know, our culture, you know, we have other people leading our culture right now. We have not been taught proper politics in order to chart our own destiny, but we have other people telling us what's right, telling us what's wrong. They basically defining everything that's going on for us. As long as we continue to allow people to define what's going on with us, then we're going to continue to remain in this situation. Nothing is going to change at us at all whatsoever. We have to overcome that fear. We have to realize the situation that we're still in, and be willing to change beyond that. And if we're not going to be able to change, you know, with the masses of the people, then we have to take that small seed, as nature teaches us, you know, and plant that small ratchet seed in the ground and let it grow from there, which we've already started to do. And you can see that by the language that Mayor Rudy Giuliani used when he said that we're in the middle of another Black Panther movement. And he was exactly correct, because we are in the middle of another strong Black Panther movement.
We have people in the Caucasian community that support the show, and he always asks the question, what can they do to help? So, Brother Yakinon, I like to ask you that question. What can they do to help us solve the problems in society?
We need money. You know, we need economics. We need opportunity. We need our own land. We need our own music. We need our own culture. We need our own educational system. You know, when we sit down and we try to talk to these Caucasians about this, you know, they turn another cheek, and the things that we're telling them, they don't agree with. We can't send our children to your schools, because on one hand, we're telling our children not to lie, but yet we give them a kiss and send them out to be lied to every morning. And then it's not until you're 30 or 40 years old and when you find out that a lot of the stuff that you were told in school were basic lies. You know, we have people who hate us who are educating us. Nobody that is going to hate you is going to teach you the truth. Like it goes back to what Elijah Muhammad said. If a man isn't going to treat you right, what makes you think he's going to teach you right? And so that's what we're dealing with. We can't be a part of this system. Integration was a huge mistake. We can't have them policing our neighborhoods. You know, we just have to have total separation from the powers that be. We have to govern ourselves. We have to choose and decide what's going to be right and chart our own destiny.
Let's talk about Houston for a minute. Now, we have a issue with the homeless. Mayor Turner is seeming to be very cruel and not very good to the homeless. What is your opinion on that matter?
It's a sad situation. You know, right across the street here, you know, we got Tent City, you know, set up, you know, maybe about 50 feet away from us right now with the homeless people. It's a sad situation. We're going to get on the ground, you know, and start seeing what we can do about it. But it's basically, you know, just a lack of resources. It's the same thing, you know, on all these different levels. People have drug problems. You know, people go through things. They have no kind of wealth saved up at all. We haven't been taught anything about economics. The only thing that we're ever taught is how to go out and get a job and work for someone else. We are not taught, you know, about business at all whatsoever. We don't know anything about stocks. You know, I just found out about stocks recently myself. You know, here I am, you know, been talking about money this, money that, you know, wealth been passed on for generations and generations, and we haven't been told about any of these things. You know, so a lot of it goes back, you know, to our education, you know, and what we need to do going forward.
Houston is a different dynamic. What can we do to change the political culture, and also what can we do to have proper representation in different areas of government?
Starting to change. You know, we were not putting forth an effort at all whatsoever. You know, Kim Ogg has been doing an excellent job, along with Vivian Green, in the DA's office. We just got a brother elected to the city council who was a part of the Huey P. Newton Gun Club. LaShadian Shimwell is his name, and this brother here is catching a lot of heat simply because we are practicing our politics like we should. And from this point, Harris County is 60% black and brown. We have actually taken over. What we have to do now is get out and make people aware of that we are in control of our own politics in Harris County. As you can see, Kim Ogg being elected and the Buy Devin campaign being started, and Devin Anderson is now gone. And so Kim Ogg, she sat down and looked at me to my face. We had a one-on-one conversation, and she let me know what she was going to do. And to this point, she's done everything that she said she was going to do. So we are definitely happy about that. We're happy about the staff she has put together in Houston, Texas, and there's a dynamic that is starting to change on the political scene. You have new leaders starting to rise up, the People's New Black Panther Party, along with a coalition that we have built here in Houston called Make a Change Coalition. We are starting to gain momentum, and we're just making it be known and for people to go ahead and start joining in. Yeah, we want all people to join and come in. You know, if whatever you're good at, whatever kind of talent you have, if it's computers, if you have good secretary skills, if you have time on your hands to come out and feed people, to talk to people, if you only able to help economically, that's fine as well. Whatever it is that you can do, we want people to start joining in, and we want to start getting a snowball effect. And then we also want to sit down and we want to start doing some critical thinking. We haven't been taught what to think. We haven't been taught how to think. You know, the only thing we've been told information, we've been told, you know, what to think exactly. You know, so we're trying to change this whole way around of our critical thinking, you know, and start getting into a room with ourselves and start to heal. You know, it's like when we get in a room with one another and we begin to talk and we begin to start working on our problems, we have to understand that we have to have a blueprint. You know, we have to have a plan. We have to follow that plan. Even if we are not the ones that's going to see it way down the line, we have to start walking that path, you know, so our children will be able to see it and to follow it on and give them some type of example. Right now, we have nothing to go on at all whatsoever. You know, in a classroom, a teacher always puts an example up on the board first before they give you a problem to solve. And that's what we're doing now. Grown men like yourself and me who are really serious about this, we're putting examples on the board. We're telling them, hey, this is the way to go. Our people are not really responding to anything but finances. Even though we see Philando Castile happen and Trayvon Martin and Mike Brown, and the list goes on and on and on, the only thing that our people seem to respond to for some reason is economics. And so if that's the only thing that they're gonna respond to, then we're getting ready to launch a strong economic plan as well, you know, for our people to go ahead and get involved in economics and start to educate themselves in that field.
Can we rebuild Black Wall Street?
Yes, I think it's very possible for us to build Black Wall Street, and that is the dream. That's what we have, our own land, our own property, our own businesses, governing ourselves. We can't have enemies running around in our neighborhood saying that they are for us, only with their words, but in their actions, they are all the way against us, and these are our enemies. And the reason I say they are our enemies is simply because when we are shot on TV, you know, we ask for all these different things, you know, and then we have these cameras where we are murdered, you know, live. They don't even render aid to us at all. But if they get a phone call from Galveston that a well or something washed ashore, they'll leave us, go down there and put water on the well all night, get a well mouth to mouth. They're more into animals than they are black lives.
Of course, I've always said that dogs in America have more rights and love than the black man and black woman. And I always said this because of what they have shown us time and time again. But Brother Yakinon, how can people get in contact with you?
They can go to peoplesnbpp@gmail.com. It's going to come directly to me. Once you send me a link, I'll send you an application out, and we can go ahead and get the process rolling from that point. But it's a very simple operation. It's not very complicated at all whatsoever, and we have chapters springing up all around the country right now. We're in a very good position, and so we're about to go on a mass recruiting spree because people are getting tired of this. They want some new leadership. They're tired of the same old rhetoric, you know, going out protesting. You know, we need power. Right now, we don't have any power at all. We need to start making some changes. Right here in Houston, Texas, we're starting to make some real serious changes, and this is going to be ground zero, and we're going to set a model right here, and we're going to extend this out into the entire country. So Colin Kaepernick as well. I wanted to speak on that situation just for a moment because I feel so bad for the brother, because that brother put his neck on the line, and you know, it goes back to unify or die. Now, had everybody been united with what was going on, or whatever Colin Kaepernick decided to do, you wouldn't see, you know, they can't block all of us out. We have power. You know, we are the ones that are pushing this industry. America is a slave-based economic system, has always been that way. That's what it's going to work on. Had those brothers been united in their efforts of doing what they were doing instead of being divided? You know, when the enemy goes after they prey, they don't go after the whole entire herd. All they want to do is separate one from everybody else and then go ahead, and key in on them. And that's what they're doing to Colin Kaepernick. Those brothers in the NFL and everybody around the world need to stand up and support that brother, because what they're doing to Colin Kaepernick is unbelievable. You know, doing the man like that, the brother stood up, you know, before some of these other brothers stood up. You know, I think about LeBron James, you know, coming on the ESPYs and, you know, dressing up in all black, sitting up, speaking a few words. Yeah, it's good as far as, you know, your voice is concerned, speaking out, but we need some action. And it's sad that a man, somebody that's mixed, you know, have to stand up and start taking action and donating money and things like that, you know, of that nature, trying to get things done on his own, and it's not a unified. You know, they speak this nonsense, you know, about they want something done, but everybody need to put their money where their mouth is. You know, we are righteous people. We need donations in order to move around. If you're scared, you can sit at home, but send us a few dollars. We're going to get out here and we're going to put that work in.
Make sure to contact Brother Yakinon if you would like to join the People's New Black Panther Party, especially those who are living in the Houston area.
All right. Appreciate you, Brother Phil. It's always an honor. And we also have a YouTube channel as well, People's New Black Panther Party. Yakinon is the creator, and we would love some subscribers. We got a video of Dr. Kaba up, you know, to get the people introduced to the party, who we are. We actually the ones that's been out here making a lot of noise. You know, we did the Sandra Bland arm rally. We did the march on the Capitol. Whenever you see the videos of David Banner, you know, that's the People's Party in the videos. Whenever you see, who else was it, Hidden Colors 4, you know, they had the Panthers in the videos. That's all the People's Party. We the ones been putting in the work, and we about to step our game up to the plate and let it be known that we ready to take over the lead. We ready to get some things done. We don't want to continue to see marches on Washington every 25 years, think that's doing something for us. You know, it's not doing nothing for us at all. We need to actually sit down with a plan and a room of people. Everybody need to put their feelings to the side for a minute. Grown men first need to sit down and have these kind of conversations. Everybody put their feelings and their emotions to the side. We need to be able to be honest with one another, and we need to have some plan of action that we need to put in place, and we need to follow through with it.